Have you been thinking about getting threads, PDO threads, thread lifts? Maybe you heard about it from the Cat Eye Lift, but you heard a lot of FUD, a lot of fear, uncertainty, and deception. A lot of people talking negative about them. What's their motive? Is it true? Are they bad? Do they create scar tissue? Can you not get a facelift after you've had a thread lift? There's a lot of ridiculous stuff out there and people just aren't in tune, they're not in touch, and you can't wish things away. Today I'm going to give you six reasons why PDO threads and threads are here to stay, why there are misconceptions, and what are those people trying to tell you? I'll get right to that point. What they're trying to say is candidates with unrealistic expectations that have too much sag that need a facelift should just get a facelift, and that's true. PDO threads are not a facelift, but a lot of people that talk negatively about them have never placed one in a face. They don't know really what they are, what they do. In fact, they're antiquated to the point where they're thinking about permanent thread lifts, polypropylene permanent threads that were from yesteryear. These are people probably wouldn't know what a digital currency is if you told them. They still use banks and antiquated systems of the economy. This is a whole new age. And as old as I am, I realize I have to be with it to give you the information that's up to date. It's why I travel the world. It's why I go see what they're doing in different countries. But the one key feature is when people talk about threads, look at the comments underneath their videos. A lot of people say, hey, I actually had them. I liked them. Hey, they were good value. They lasted. They gave me a window into maybe what a facelift was. That's what threads are. I'm going to tell you what they do and why they're going to stay. Just for those who don't know, there are different materials, PDO, polydioxinone, PCL, polycaprolactone, and PLLA, similar to what's in Sculptra, poly-L-lactic acid. They all dissolve, so to speak, and they go away over time. PDO, then PCL, then PLLA, in about that continuum of longevity. The PDO are the shortest ones. I'll tell you actually why, even though they last the shortest amount of time, a lot of people end up going for those type of threads. They just kind of hit the sweet spot. But they're put underneath the skin to rejuvenate, to build collagen. There are smooth and twist threads that build collagen, and then there are the lifting ones. And I think those are the ones that threaten people the most because people are afraid that maybe they're gonna lose business from it, or maybe the people are gonna get thread lifts thinking they're a facelift. These products are a tool in a practice. Most people walk into a practice, let's say 40, 50, 60 years of age, and they've had 30, 40, 56 years of aging. You can't hit that with one thing. You can't have one tool in your toolbox. You don't go to a home, build a home with a hammer or even an air gun or a single saw. You have all kinds of different tools. The same with a face. Think of PDO threads as a tool in the toolbox of your practitioner to thwart the many dozens of years of aging of bone, of fat, of muscle, of hyper muscle movement. So think of it as a tool, and yes, people are correct when they say a lot of people end up being sold a thread lift when they really aren't satisfactory patients or appropriate patients to get that result from. And many people who do need a facelift to get the long-term result they want are looking for a quick fix. That's an inappropriate use, and it's inappropriate for someone to do that procedure on someone with that expectation in mind. That's my feeling on it. However, they work, and that's number one that you need to know, is they stay and they're here forever, and they've been in other countries. I started doing them 10 years ago. Because they work. And you see from the comments, people who, like any other product, if you're going to get your Botox, if you're going to get your filler, if you're going to get your rhinoplasty, if you're going to get fat transfer, if you're going to get a facelift, the consult is the most important part of it. And appropriate candidates with appropriate expectations are going to love PDO threads because they work. If things don't work, they go away. Think of hyaluron pen, gone. Did a video on that. Did two of them. Said it was terrible. It's gone. Plasma pen, okay, so you burn holes in the skin expecting a blepharoplasty, a facelift, that's ridiculous. Gone. You can buy both of those things for $40 on Amazon. I'd advise you not to. So that's number one. They actually do work, build collagen, give skin glow, and they do lift in the appropriate patient in combination procedures. Number two is they're time tested. This isn't something that's been, yes, 5-6 years ago, a group of us in this country got together, and from there on, they took hold, and many more people do them. They're growing. I would say probably the number one fastest growing procedure is thread lifting. I don't like the word thread lifting, but those threads type of procedures are the number one growing procedure in the past 4 or 5 years in the United States, but they've been in other countries for a long time, and they're countries that are way ahead of us in terms of techniques and materials. I see it all the time overseas in Central America. And that led me to my number three point. It's country tested. It's not like it's being marketed, it's being put on social media, and Americans are doing this, Canadians, North America, Mexico. No, all around the world, this has been going on forever, even in countries where social media isn't revered like it is in the United States. It grew by word of mouth, by people desiring the procedures, by people getting great results. So it's also not only time tested, but country tested. Number four, and an argument against it, is it's temporary. Well, guess what? Botox and Botox-like products are temporary. Fillers are temporary. Biostimulators are temporary. Peels are temporary. RF microneedling and microneedling without energy is temporary. And a stunner, but a facelift is temporary. So yes, a rhinoplasty would be something what would be more on the permanent side, yes. Blepharoplasty is temporary, if you want to think about it. Many people get two, many people get three or four rhinoplasties or nose jobs. People before ligamentous release, especially in the face, would get three or four facelifts. Now that's less common. But what isn't temporary? So it's not an argument against threads that they're temporary. It actually can be a benefit, but it's a lot longer lasting than many procedures because type 1 and 3 collagen is produced. And if you take care of your skin, your aging rate, you keep it low, they can last and they can be great. Number five, skin is in. It just happens to be that people now revere great skin. That wasn't always the case. People wanted more fillers, more lips, more ducks, fish, trout pelt. They wanted the animal look, the cat eyes and the cat cheeks. But skin, good, beautiful skin is in, and I'll do a complete video on what is beautiful skin, what is healthy looking skin, what is glowing skin, what are the components that make it? But threads are one of those components. Collagen, elastin, glow. Just like you get that with Sculptra, PLLA, and there are PLLA threads, you get it with PDO and PCL. In fact, in Korea, we used PCL, polycaprolactone, in a liquid form. I have a complete video on this channel. And I think I called it liquid PDO maybe, or liquid PDO, liquid PCL. Go back and watch that video. But it's injected as small particles, 50 microns and less, of PDO, PCL, and PLLA. Of course, we have as Sculptra. Those are, we consider, I call them biostimulators. And finally, number six is cost. A lot of people would say, hey, these threads are expensive. Okay. A facelift, a Hollywood facelift, what, $50,000 to $250,000? Is that expensive? I don't know. For me, it would be. I just happy to get a hockey stick for $150. You know, that's what they cost. I find that expensive. But a facelift is expensive. So threads, are they expensive? For type 1 and 3 collagen that you get, that you own, that stays, for a lifting effect, let's say you get a lifting effect for 6 months to a year and a half, it's the average price in this country would be $1,000 to $2,500. Think about what your $100,000 facelift costs over time. So everything's expensive, and we're at an inflation rate of, I think, 15%. And I've said this on my AMIT course to my students for the last 2 years, get ready for inflation. We're at 15%. So everything's going up. Plan on aesthetics going up by 15%. That's the way it is. But everything's expensive. I don't believe for the price for what you get in the appropriate candidate that it's more expensive than any other procedure. That's the point. So I would submit that it isn't that expensive, and compare it to surgical procedures that are extremely expensive. And I like surgical procedures. I look forward to getting mine at one point. It'll be great. So I'm not against any of it. I think it all works together and it's all what each individual wants. But we know 99% of people do not want surgery. They may need it to get the look that's in their mind, but they might also then compromise and say, well, I'll save myself $50,000 or $75,000. Maybe I'm not going to get quite a facelift result, but I'll get beautiful glowing skin, a little fine tuning, look the best that I can be without surgery. It's personal choice, whatever floats your boat. I have no vested interest, but I have a vested interest in giving you the best information that I know, that I learn in practice from my own patients and my own practice to bring it to you. Take it for what it's worth. A complete playlist up here on PDO threads, thread lifts, even the cat eye I threw in there, and one down here on things you can do at home. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.